Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we had a great Congress in Prague. This time we have approved a Prague Declaration by our General Assembly. This declaration is a statement from ISPRS community. We're telling people that we should work together to promote a global geospatial information infrastructure and platforms, because one individual, one organization, one country could not develop a reliable global geoinformation, and we could not develop advanced geospatial computing platform by ourselves. We need to work together. We not only visit ISPS community, but also with other societies. So this time we had also got our ISPS vision paper published. Okay, we'll issue strong scientific voice to the world. I do hope in the coming 4 years, we have more similar scientific voices prepared and announced to the world. Thank you.
Yes, so I'm Lawrence Friedl. I work with NASA's Earth Science Division, and so I work out of Washington, D.C., and NASA has centers across the country. I really do a lot in international collaboration, looking at the Earth as a complete system. So NASA looks at, with satellites, it looks at the land, the oceans, the atmosphere, and how all those interact. And increasingly, we're sort of seeing much more on the sort of human impacts, whether it's management issues or policy issues. We're seeing those impacts on the Earth and the Earth system. So in the panel today, one thing that I think was a really important message that I heard was really the opportunities that the private sectors and the private sector companies are gonna come up with. They got a lot of different approaches to be doing remote sensing and taking all these observations in space. And so we're really looking to sort of see, as they look to expand some of the markets and some of the users, we want to be working with them to see how is that we can take some of the data that the governments have been providing, which may be beyond the sort of imagery, and looking at things like precipitation and land surface temperatures and all that. How can we work with them to blend that data, which is free and open, with the data that they have that they're going to be, you know, selling? And how can they use some of the government provided data into the products and services to really enhance the use of remote sensing overall?
So thank you for this opportunity, and I would like to invite all the delegates for tomorrow's special session on cultural heritage, which is organized by SIPA. SIPA is the Scientific Committee on Heritage Documentation. We are the son or the daughter of ISPRS and ICOMOS. ICOMOS is the International Council of Monuments and Sites. We are going to have a number of papers that are going to address technical challenges in documenting cultural heritage. A great contribution from ISPRS delegates and people attending the conference. So I want to take the opportunity to invite you to Ottawa, Canada. So next year we are organizing the Heritage Documentation Symposia, the 26th version of this important event. And I am one of the co-chairs. It's the first time that this SIPA symposia is organized in North America. We're aiming at bringing people from ISPRS, ICOMOS, and other organizations working on the field of heritage documentation. It will be a great opportunity to meet decision makers, professionals, educators, and other people that are interested in the topic.
It is just 8 days after that when I was here last week, and we made a film, short video about the Congress Hall, like an invitation for all participants. And it was completely different here. Everything was empty, and we saw all the area. And now it is full of people who came to the Congress and who, I see, enjoy the Congress. And the Congress brought several new things, like National Mapping and Agency Fora and the Space Agency Fora. These were special events organized by two specialists, and they invited speakers from all over the world to cover the high topic and most important topics, both in the space industry and also National Mapping Agency industry, I would say. And these meetings very well attended, and we are still before the end of them. Last session is in the afternoon. And I believe people who attended them or the other sessions or other events like exhibition area and also social events are happy with the Congress. I heard some rumor that they were happy, but I believe I would be happy, and I told them I would be happy to hear it after the Congress. So we are doing, my team is doing our best to fit for the people to feel in a good conference, to feel they are really cordially welcome, and they will like ISPRS and also all events organized by ISPRS.